Tennis ace Alex Ayala is through to the semifinals of the W60 Madrid tournament after crushing number 3 seed Jamie Forlis. Ayala easily upset the Aussie with a 6-1, 6-4 win. The 17-year-old is set to face 16th seed Catherine Sebov of Canada in the semis this afternoon, Manila time. Filipino gymnast Caloy Yulo makes history again. The 22-year-old on Friday became the first Filipino to clinch a gold in the Artistic Gymnastics Asian Championship after reigning in the men's floor exercise. The win comes just a day after a silver medal finish in the men's individual all-around. The two-time world champion will also compete in the finals vault and parallel bars today, Saturday. It's all systems go for the inauguration of Vice President-elect Sara Duterte in her hometown Davao City on Sunday. Joyce Balancho joins us live with the latest. Joyce, go ahead.
Yes, Rain, we chanced upon Vice President-elect Sara Duterte as she was entering the Davao City Hall building early this morning. Now, she said she has a lot to do in her office today, which includes some courtesy calls of ambassadors who personally requested to meet her before attending her inauguration tomorrow. Asked about the last-minute preparations for her oath-taking, she said she is personally writing her own inaugural message, which as we speak, Rain, is still being readied. She wants the message to be as short, as they could not predict how the weather will be tomorrow afternoon. She intends to focus on the promises that she gave during the campaign. Now, between her inauguration tomorrow and on assuming office on the afternoon of June 30, she said she will be having a very jam-packed schedule. On Monday, June 20, she plans to attend the flag-raising ceremony here in Davao City Hall to formally bid farewell to the LGU employees. She will also be gracing several oath-taking events of her regional party, Hugpong ng Pagbabago, also Juan Cebu, among others. Now, asked where she will reside, Vice President-elect Duterte said they plan to use temporarily the existing office of the Vice President, that is the reception house in Quezon City, while they are still looking for a permanent place to stay. But she wants it to be her own project to put up a permanent office and residence, which can be used hopefully by the future Vice Presidents. Also during the interview, Rain, she shared what local programs she intended to bring to the national government.
Dadalhin namin is number one, magnegosyo taday, peace building in the communities, the peace 911, and yung advocacy ko sa Pagbabago campaign, which is campaigning for the emphasis on education sa kabataan and responsible parenthood sa ating mga magulang. Divide my time, each office, meron silang kani-kanilang, meron ako sinet up na kanya-kanyang teams so that each team will only focus on one office. So that hindi sila kalat na sa kanilang trabaho. And then, I will mostly be with the Department of Education since yun ang critical sa atin ngayon, especially that we are coming out of the pandemic. And then itong nandito sa Office of the Vice President, ang dadalhin na lang naman namin our projects that we already did here in Davao City. So ang ano lang doon is i-roll out siya sa iba't ibang lugar na sa Pilipinas. So that will be easier to do.
Rain, Vice President-elect Sara Duterte said among her personal guests tomorrow are her children and some relatives from the Zimmerman, Duterte, and Carpio families. Some senators and ambassadors will also be attending her inauguration tomorrow. Rain?
Thank you so much for that report. Joyce Balancho from Davao City.